is about the banks of the river. Transformation is happening every minute, even every second, as people have an encounter with God, poverty is tackled, corruption is uprooted, souls come to Christ, churches are planted. That's all transformation. But the kind of transformation that eventually will allow an entire nation, and not only one nation, but many nations, to be discipled, and then to come into the presence of God as safe nations, as pictured in Revelation 21, requires something else. So the transformation that we see day in and day out is transformation that happens in the context of a lagoon, a swamp. That's a very good thing. But the problem is that anything that is in a lagoon or a swamp, it doesn't go beyond the swamp. But in a river, it's a different story, because the water in the river moves on and on and on and fertilizes many, many things. So what is the basic difference between a swamp and a river? Banks. If you put banks to a swamp, the water now rises up when it hits the banks, finds the incline in the terrain, breaks through the edge of the swamp, and eventually begins to take life all over. In this movement, we believe in placing banks. And one side of the banks is prayer evangelism. The other one is the five pivotal paradox. I have two books dedicated to explaining these two banks. One is titled Prayer Evangelism. The other one is Transformation. But let me give you the elevator version. Prayer evangelism comes out of Luke 10, where Jesus instructed us to bless rather than to curse people that are antagonistic, to fellowship with them rather than avoid them, to minister to them rather than judge them, and then and only then to proclaim the kingdom of God has come. So four steps: we bless, we fellowship, we minister, we proclaim. That is the lifestyle, not a program, a lifestyle by which we live out the five pivotal paradigms, which are like this. We are called not just to disciple people, but to disciple nations. That's paradigm number one, and that describes the what. Paradigm number two, Jesus didn't die just for souls, he died for everything that was lost. That's paradigm number two. And that means that the marketplace has been redeemed by Jesus and now must be reclaimed. The first paradigm addresses the what, the second addresses the why. Now we move into paradigm number three and number four that address the how. And it's so simple. Paradigm number three, everybody is a minister, and labor is the premier expression of worship this side of heaven. Which means that as people go to work, as people carry on their responsibilities Monday through Saturday, they are worshiping God as ministers. And paradigm number four explains that when we take the kingdom of God where the gates of Hades are, those gates collapse, and the Lord is able to build the church beyond the four walls of the church. And paradigm number five is that transformation must be tangible. And the premier expression of transformation is the elimination of systemic poverty. So everything you're gonna hear from us about transformation honors the philosophical DNA which is in the scriptures, but it introduces an operational DNA that is giving results, and I know it will help you obtain those results. So remember, put banks to the swamp, turn it into a river, and you will see transformation impacting regions beyond your current sphere of influence.